I'm Julie from The Prepared Pantry, and today I'm going to show you how to make mini pannekuchen, or as I like to call, baby Dutch baby. So, it's really easy and you can turn them into super cute dessert cups so you can serve to your friends for breakfast or dessert or dinner or whenever. Okay, now to start, you're going to use a jumbo muffin pan, and what I've done is filled it with a little bit of butter, just a little slice of butter each. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is put it in the oven. This is preheated to 425. And this will be just long enough to melt the butter. Okay, now I'm gonna make the mix. It's so easy. All you have to do is put half cup of milk, which I have right here, and two eggs. Just crack them into the bowl here. And I like to use a bowl with a spout so it's easier to pour in the muffin pan once it's heated. All right, so there's our two eggs. And then now for the mix, we just have this classic pannekuchen mix that we sell here that I'm gonna use. And it's just half a cup, so I'm just gonna dump that in right there. And now all you have to do is just mix it up with a whisk for just till it's, you know, nice and smooth. Shouldn't take too long. Okay, it's looking pretty smooth to me. Okay, so this is nice and smooth, and now our butter should be melted. Yep, it's nice and melted. It's kind of sizzling a little bit. So I'm just going to put it right here on this cooling rack. And then I'm going to take the batter and dump it into each, pour it into each cup, just like this. The trickiest part here is pouring it evenly into each of the cups. But if you have to spoon it from one to the other, that's totally fine. Okay. Now, as you can see, there's one in every cup here. Let's try to tilt it up just a little bit, and the butter is kind of floated to the top. So now I'm gonna put it in the oven, again at 425. I'm gonna bake it for 9 to 10 minutes until it kind of poofs up. It has a really magical effect, so I'll be back in 9 to 10 minutes. Okay, we're back. The timer just went off for 9 minutes, so I'm gonna go ahead and check them. And they are certainly done. Look, they've puffed up nice and huge. They have kind of this magical effect. So now what we're gonna do is, you can see they're kind of, the butter has risen to the top and it's kind of in the middle now. And so I'm gonna take them out of the pan. Now usually they're cool enough, you can usually just grab them. Or what I like to do is use this, it's called my favorite spatula. So you just kind of go around and circle around so you can get it out of the pan. Like this, and we'll just set it right here on the cooling rack. And in just a minute, I'll show you how to dress them up. Okay, I've taken them all out of the pan and I've moved them onto this cooling rack right here. So as you can see, we have a whole bunch of these cute little dessert cups. And now it's time for the fun part. We get to dress them up. And this is where you can get creative. You can do blueberries, bananas, strawberries, anything you want. But this is definitely the kind of dessert that you want to serve right away because they look and taste best right when they come out of the oven. Okay, so here's what I'm going to do. I've decided I'm going to put in a little bit of Bavarian cream. This is just a tube of pastry filling that we sell here. So just squish a little bit out here in the middle. And then while these were baking, I decided to chop up some strawberries. So here's some right here. I'm just going to dump it in like that. It's just really quick and easy. Okay, and then now, I'm just gonna cover it with some of this vanilla cream syrup that we also sell here. This stuff is really good. Okay, and then now I'm going to put on just some of this regular old light whipped cream. Now sometimes we like to whip our own, but this is just fast and easy, so I'm gonna do it today. Just put some on top like that. And then sometimes at the end, I just like to put on a little bit of powdered sugar, just like that. Just kind of dust it off. And as you can see, we now have nice, pretty dessert. Now, just so you know, it actually tastes good. I will sacrifice and take one for the team and taste it.
That is good.
Well, thanks for joining us today and learning how to make baby Dutch babies or mini pannekuchen.